Yes. This is data editor window. The data editor window, as the name implies, that's where you edit data. So the data editor window has two views. The data view, the variable view, and the data view. Of course, the variable view is where you put in the name of the, if you can see now, the name of the variable you are seeing here. You are not seeing anything apart from the name of the variable. Age, sex, weight, height. So I will come and explain, because what I was explaining when that thing started going on now, I've not started explaining each of them because I have to explain each of them. I just first of all introduce us to the, I was just talking about the window, the icons, those icons on the window. And some of them are like any window icon, like edit, file, view, the same function they perform in any window, like a word. But the ones that are unique to SPSS are not this edit, view, and file. They are the data, transform, analyze. I think I was explaining the data. You do a lot of things in data, like what we're going to be doing, data, selecting, splitting. If you are making noise from your head, I'll just mute you. Because if there's noise from your head, you will be disturbing the whole class. I'll just mute you. But if you want to talk, you can now unmute yourself. Now, if you know that there's noise, you can mute yourself. Now, under the data, you will see something like split file. In a situation where you are doing urban rural, comparative two group or four group, three group, you want to analyze based on the different group, you can split. Though there's a provision, if that particular variable is for splitting, you can put it here. I will explain that. Then the one usually used to split, then select cases you want to select, want to analyze all, want to select the case to analyze, want to knock out the other, or want to, you can also use the select to have cut off. I was giving an example. Diabetic, how do you diagnose that diabetic? You people with blood sugar, you do the blood sugar, and I say blood sugar greater than or equal to 126. Diabetic. So one is just select, that one will be yes. You will see it, we'll do it. Yes. That one will be no. You have that automatic. So all those things you do it on that data. On that transform, that's where you do a lot of things like compute new variable like BMI now. If you want to do BMI, you don't need to use that to be calculating it. You know, somebody has done it before. You wanted to do it, you know, after taking the weight for each participant and height, that use a calculator for each questionnaire. No, plenty questionnaire calculated BMI. When he brought this, I said, why should you do this? He said, I said, the computer will give the instruction. He said, we just suffer ourselves. So it's there, we do the transformation. If we want to range age, that's where we do our transformation. Analyze, that's where the cross of the matter, all the analysis you are doing is under analyze. Mark direct marketing. This one is talking to you about their new product, other product they have, and the new version of all these things, so you can get information there. Graph, there the word graph. What I discover over time is that it's just there as useless as it, because the same graph under the analyze, we can plot the same graph. And the only graph we plot here are the ones that are for continuous variable. Other graph, yes, they give better graph than, so we can plot it. Even all those other graphs can be plotted under the analysis. So you may not even go to graph to do that. There is there. Then utilities. This one also talk about other things. Apart from the SPSS, other products, you can use their software to do. So, and this add-on, then Windows. This window, what is just a simple thing. You know, I told you that as you click on open a particular file that is already in SPSS, it will open this data editor window. I also open the sort window. Look at the tool window now. If you look at, okay, let me, hope you are seeing what I'm doing. Let me
Yes, we're seeing it.
Yes. I just want to, if you look at, as I click on the window now, if you look at it, we have one, output, two, BMI saved. You know, the document I open is BMI. So this one is the, look at start data editor window. This one, viewer, statistic viewer, viewer window. So the one we are looking at now is data editor window. That's why it marked it. If I want to change to the other window, the viewer window, where the result goes to, I just click on it. Can you see? I don't know if you can see it or I should share it. It may not show you unless I share. Can you see the viewer window or is it showing you data editor window? Somebody should talk. You unmute yourself.
It's still data editor window.
Most of the time, because of Zoom, I have to go and share that one separately. Can you see now? I've shared it. And you can see the viewer window now.
Yes.
If you go back to that something, can you see now? It marked that result window as the one that we are dealing with. Number one. This by the result window. Look at it. Can you see? It marked that viewer window. That is where we are. We are not in data result window. Can you see that is the so but you can use the icon on your taskbar because if you over the on the SPSA icon, your data bar, it will be showing you the two windows also, which you can click. So there are two ways you can navigate between the two windows. That's what help is, just like help in any other thing. But let me tell you something, the help here cannot help you. It's a help. Most of this software, the software just say help, but the only software, few software help, like MVivo for qualitative analysis. I learned it through the help. But this one, because the people that do the software, they are not statisticians, they cannot even teach it. Their own, most of the time, they even employ statisticians to tell them, okay, this is the formula, they are programmer. So when they put some of the things they put there, it's just, but you can see good book on experts that know how to use statistics. How to use statistics, that one will help you. That's like true. This one, some other book. So don't let us waste time on that. Let me go back to that data editor window. Data editor window. So people are coming now. I want to. So I'm so sorry for what happened the other time. But now, yes. You cannot hear me.
Can hear you.
Okay, somebody was making noise on the ground. Okay, I don't know. This one I just said. Any question? But people are just coming. Blossom, you just came. Ify, you just came.
Yeah.
Any question on what I've just done now? I proceed.
Yeah, but I don't know.
Talk, please.
But I think even his generation, actually his generation particularly, they didn't involve themselves in anything. But if the child was going in the wrong
direction. Madam Blossom,
are you talking to Ross or Blossom? Are you talking to Ross or you are talking to someone else?
Yeah.
Blossom.
No,
mute her.
Those ones used to be very hard.
Yeah, mute her.
Mute her for a while.
Who want to have mute her? If Foma wanted to talk, okay, he's raising hand. If Foma is raising hand.
Yes, please. I want to ask, have you imported the Excel data into the SPSS? Because I don't know how to do that.
I have not done that. We have not read that place. Don't worry, we'll do it. If you look, I've not done that one. I'm just explaining. I'm just explaining the window to you. We'll do that. Don't worry. You do that. Because that is why I gave you two files. There's one Excel, there's one SPSS. That was why I deliberately gave that Excel.
Yes.
And we change it to SPSS. I have the SPSS format. I deliberately do that.
Okay.
Don't worry. Okay, all maybe right. We should proceed. You proceed. So, yes, sometimes also I will allow some people that have, because we have some other facilitators. Dr. Larry is here, Dr. Balogun. Anytime you may want to explain something. So that it won't be only one person. So, it's only not only one facilitator. Dr. Balogun is here. He's a surgeon. You know, this surgeon, they want to know everything. They want to know how to tie out everything, do the surgery. I also know all this more than the people that are doing it. So, it's good. You'll be surprised that the person that is teaching here is present in National Postgraduate and Orthopedic Surgery. So it's interesting. Most of the people that want to come and learn this in their surgery, I don't know why. So it's okay. So Dr. Balogun once in a while will be coming in also to explain some things. Now, I think you understand this icon now. The most important are the data transform analyze. Those are the things you actually need here. They will be most useful for you. So I'll see, come and explain all those other things. Okay, now let's quickly explain. If you go to viewer window also, it's the same icon you listed there. So it doesn't really matter. And you can even access the icon from each of the window. Now, let's look at this data editor window and let us look at the variable view first. So the first thing you do, look at, I can even open one, we can demonstrate. But let's first of all look at what we do. Maybe I should just do that along the way. Let me, I want to open new. New just mean that empty. I can still go back to the down. I don't know if you see, let me share it because you may not likely see. I don't know if you saw that. So you can see what I just opened now. It's quite different from the other one. This is data variable. Let's start with variable. You know, in your study also, you start with variable. The variable, and let your number one variable be serial number. Very, very important. You know why? When you are entering your data, you have your questionnaire or your pro forma, or where you have listed those observations. You know, it's good to number the one to your the total number of your sample size. When you are entering into SPSS or Excel, you will still go to Excel later. When you are entering into database like this, you should create a variable called number also. Don't say there's number in SPSS because the number is just for the SPSS. It doesn't go into your data. When you have a problem, you're looking for it, it will not go into it. So the first variable should be serial number. You can have other ID number, whatever, that serial number, the way you have number your questionnaire or whatever, physically put it down there. The reason being that there may be mistake in entering data. When we are running it, like for example, you have just run the age. You just see this, all of them are adults. You now see 7. How can adult be 7-year-old? It may be a mistake. Maybe 72 or 73 or 27. Some one figure is missing somewhere. So it is when you know, oh, which number is that? You trace it, okay, this is a number. You now go and look at your paper and now look where is number 7, in number whatever, it's not number 7, any number it is. If it's number 20 something, now look at it. Now if it's a mistake or whatever. So it's not only that, only age, anything. So if you detect any problem in your data set, it is the numbering that will help you locate the physical where to check. Maybe there's a mistake or what happened. So that is one of the major that some people just enter. No, by the time they cannot trace when you have over 400 questions. I wish you be searching. Which one? So that is, you have to be systematic from the beginning. So serial number. And one thing with that, once you put something down, you'll see what it will do. It will give you some default value. So you will see that for your variable view, is arranged, the name is vertical. You want to arrange the variable horizontally. The name of the characteristic of the variable is on the vertical axis. This is the name of the variable, either age or serial number or whatever. This is the type. You want, that is the type you want to type in. Are you going to type number in, which is numeric, or you going to type anything in? When you say anything, it can be number, it can be letter. That is string. Okay, don't worry. I think it's better just put serial number, you see. But once I put that, it will stimulate some of those discussions. Can you see? By default, you say numeric. But it may not be numeric, but expresses encourage you to make everything numeric. Anything you want to enter, almost everything to make a number. But don't worry. It may not be quantitative variable. It may be category, but make it number. So if you don't want to make it number, you have option. When you click on it, can you see? You click on that thing. This is the numeric number one by default. It may be comma, it may be dot, it may be date. You want to put it, it may be the naira. Naira. The other one, the most after numeric, the most important one is string. String means you type either letter or number. In if it is a P4 or some other software, they call it alphanumeric. Alpha means letter, numeric. That is, you can type both letter and number. Whereas the numeric, you can only type number there. But whereas when it is string, when you can type both number and letter, you cannot use that. If you type number there, you cannot use that number for calculation. You cannot use to run any statistical calculation as per you want to calculate the mean or whatever. No. It doesn't see it as something you can do calculate operation, mathematical operation on. Even if it is number, since you have already said it's string. That is that. So let's leave it at numeric. You will see something, okay, because this is serial number. Let me put something like age here. Would I be going? Maybe after our serial number, the number one thing most of the time is age. It may not be age. Sometimes we use group. You know, if you are dealing with many groups, it's not only one group. It's not only one group, study, two group, three group, four group. There will be a variable that separate them. You also put me. I usually put after the serial number, if it is a category, I will put group first before the lead something, maybe age now start. Doesn't really matter, but. So if you look at it, immediately you type something, it gives you default value. But you cannot change it to what you want. Let me explain. I've explained numeric. Then age, this name, it does not allow you to put gap. Look at it. This age now, I cannot put age of. Can you see? You knock it out. It doesn't allow. So some people now put underscore, but me, I prefer if it is a description, like age of participant, of children. I will just say of, I will write that in cap, the first word capital. Participant. If I want to display anything, you know, sometimes maybe have you heard of this? Heard of tuberculosis? So it doesn't allow you to give gap everything together. If you want to give by some people underscore, when you put underscore, they won't allow you to put a dash because dash is minus. It's a mathematical operation inside. It doesn't allow, but underscore, no underscore now. When you see, Le Marita. Marita. No, it will not allow me gap status. I can see underscore status. Can you see? Can you see? Some people do that. But me, I prefer writing together and put that status capital, the first capital, I can separate it. However, it doesn't really matter. If you just keep it short, name short, when you come here, it allows you to label it. Under the labeling here, it allows you to say, like now, age of participant with graph, age of, can you see? Allow you to sentence. So sometimes when you are entering into SPSS like that, especially when you are not the one that will even be who will do the analysis, you want to send to somebody, so that people will understand your thought. After you have put it, you can just, even so, what some people even do is that, they put Q1, Q2. They all do all this of question one, question two. And now come to label, explain age of this. Marita tells of this. Sense of participant. No description. I've heard of tuberculosis. Relationship with the patient. You know, all those things. You can tap it there. But when you do it, that's what will appear. You'll be seeing if somebody is looking. So maybe somebody that I want to analyze doesn't know your work. So it's a description of your questionnaire. So it will understand, okay, this is age of. So that is what the label. And me, I don't do labeling anyway. But it's good to do labor, especially when you are not the one analyzing it. You are not the one analyzing it. So that it's good. So that if you labor it very well, you take it to another person, you'll be able to understand, go through. Many people, when you enter it, they labor it well, go through their questionnaire and look at it, familiarize with the questionnaire to look at it, how they enter to really know which very good get. It makes me to quickly grasp it. Now, I just keep for that to that label so that you understand. Numeric, then you will see width. The next one is width. The width here means how many characters, if you type, that will appear. Because when you, like the age of participant, if I say age character now, this age of participant is long. Though it appears there as age of participant, inside the when I'm running the analysis, you are running the analysis, it will show the first age. Character, it cannot take one. But you can increase it. Look at it. You can take and increase it to as you know. You can decrease it or increase it. Doesn't matter. You just giving the default. As the former one was 6, the former version, initially 6. Maybe even the new one, and maybe it's 9 or 10. They put there, or the newer version. So I don't know, like the one, I don't know which one did I click now. Maybe it's this version 20. I have version 25, I have 23 here. Yeah, I like taking things so that anybody that have lower version, I can familiarize. I don't want anybody to feel somehow because there's no money, there's no difference there. So this is where marketers, they just keep on doing. Though there are some companies that engage them, that buy those things, so that need new features. So that they are selling those ones. So now decimal. Once how many decimal places? Because there are some things like height now. Height in meter comes in 2 decimal. That's something you measure come in 1 decimal, 3 decimal, depends. Depends on the, if there's no decimal, you can say you can reduce it to 0. Because if you don't reduce it to 0, if you enter anything there, it will be, if you allow the decimal by default, it will do 0.00, 0.00, 0.00. All your data set, you just say 0.00. Making it. So if you have no decimal, you can reduce it to 0, no decimal. That's not mean there. There's no decimal. If there's decimal, you indicate it to your decimal places. Because if you don't indicate, it will not show. Want it to show the decimal. So then I've talked about this label. Then let's come to value. Now, you know that, look at this one now. There are something, you say your type of variable is numeric. By default, you want it to show. You can show string. But if you choose numeric, if it is age, age is numeric naturally. Anything that is number is numeric. Number of children, hemoglobin concentration, blood pressure, weight, height, all those things that are number. Or maybe you do like SQ, you have put number there. They are numeric by nature. But sex, I didn't put sex. After age is sex. I can insert. Can you say, I just insert. Say, I want to bring sex before the marital status. All I need to do is to over that marital status, I just right click on the 5, not over the marital, under the line. And now right click and I say insert. If that's inside, not say variable zero because it doesn't have name. I'm not say sex. Put it there. Sex. Now, you can reduce it to, you know, sex now and marital status, we leave them as numeric and even the group. But they are not actually, their real value are not numeric, male, female. So label value means that what does one indicate? If you say, I'm putting one, how do you want to code it? You now click on it. Can you see value? You click on it, it shows you something like this. You can now say, okay, one, male. You click on hard to make it. You now click on two. Female, you click on add, see, okay. So, can you see? You can check it anytime. So, what he's telling is that because you are going to enter one for male, two for female, you have labeled it. It's only labeling that will help you to enter it. It's you that will enter. You can already say numeric. If you say, if you didn't say numeric, if you say string, you can see enter one or two there. Doesn't really matter. But, if it is numeric, I will tell you the disadvantage of that later. But it's numeric now. you can easily, you know, when you get to data view, enter one, any number there. But you want to, you want to label the number you are. When I enter one, no, it's male. When I enter two, it's male. It doesn't stop you from making mistake of entering five there. You can make the mistake. But of course, when you are running your data, you will see five. Okay, there's no, and since you didn't label five, it will come out as five. It will not come out as male or female. It will come out as five. So that's part of the reasons you number. If you give numbering, you now go and check that number. Okay, what is the sex of that person? I made mistake in entering something else. So you go and check. But your one can make mistake. So that is the label. Like marital status, now we can decide to say one single, two married. So you can be talking, so that I can be interactive. What of theory? Theory is what? Separated. Or
divorce.
Five, widowed, right?
Yes.
So that's it. Okay. I've done it for you. Like this group now, let's say you are having two groups now. Let's say group one is urban. Or rural, or whatever. Urban. Group two, rural. Depend. You can say it may be case control. Group two. So it depends on, I'm just giving an example. Rural. So that's how to label it. I'll label our group. Now let's come to missing value. You see. Come to missing value. If you click on it, you see, by default, it gives you no missing value. By default. And that's what I usually use. I didn't like. Then it now gives you different ways. And here, if you click, it gives you three options. Here, you can give you a range of value. Low or high, better. Usually use this one if you want to use missing. Why it does that is that sometimes when you, there are some question non-response, they didn't respond. When they are entering in, they own the value for that, they didn't answer that question. Maybe when my task, they didn't see it. The person is separated or divorced, didn't want to see it. Maybe didn't answer. Or sometimes it's not only that the person didn't answer, it may be. It really, it may be not relevant. Like, you know that some question is based on some other question. Let's say, if yes to question not, this, not, this. Not, so not, if no, it's not relevant. You want to ask question, Dr. Taiwo. If no, that question is not relevant.
Not
so,
applicable.
Thank you, sir. Not applicable. So the reason for the missing may not applicable. It may be that the person, I don't know. Maybe he doesn't know. You ask for something, he doesn't know. It may be that the person decides not to answer. So there are many reasons. So this one gives you up to three options. So what you do now is now give a number. But that number is actually a number that should be outside the range of the number. Like, for example, now, if it is under age, you want to put that missing value. You make sure that if you have up to 80 something, you make sure that the missing value, what you're going to put as a missing value, should be far, should be outside the range of that value. That's why you see 99. Maybe nobody is up to 99 or 999 or 999. So you can now put, okay, for missing value for this one, or maybe age now, you may say that, okay, for the age now, you may say, I want to put 999. Or 99, if the person is not applicable or the person doesn't know, 999, if the person decides not to say it. No, you may not know the age or decide not to say it. Or if there's another reason, you can say 9999 or you can say 777. Just give one figure. So you remember when you do percussion, 99, all those 99, something like that. So just give arbitrary value. But me, I don't even like using it because even when you are running the analysis, somehow the SPS also give you even the frequency of the missing value, the one that are missing, also give you. That is good. Now, if you want to classify reason, different reason for the missing value, you know, all those things that are missing, there are different reasons for different people. They now give all those options. When you give all those options, it helps you to sort it out. Okay, all these, or there are five of them because they don't know. These five or about six of them because they don't want to answer. That is the essence of the missing value. But you may not use it. That's why the option is no missing value. No missing value doesn't mean that there won't be any missing value, but you don't want to code any missing value. And that is what I tell you. Then you see column. You see by default, put 8. You see what's different between width and column. This width, what it does is that the name of the variable, the number it that will appear if you type the name of the variable. Then the other one, the column, the number, the value. You know, for example, now, if you say monthly income, the word monthly income is the name of the variable. So the number of character that will show inside will be width. Then if you type maybe 1 million or 5 million or 1,600,000 something. So the number of character of the input that we show, that is the column. I don't know if you can differentiate between width and column now. So somebody also you have to set it. Okay, yeah. Somebody want to ask question. Ask your question, please.
I didn't get that explanation, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, can you take it again, sir?
Yeah, I'll go back. I'll go back on it. So thank God that at least this time. Hope everybody that was around is around now, because I wasn't happy the other time. And I don't want anybody. They sent text to me that Dr. Moroni can not be able to join. No problem. Okay, he's here. He's here. Okay. Dr. Moroni can I now? Dr. Moroni can you unmute yourself if you want to talk, you on, because if you are talking, I may not hear you.
I'm here, sir.
Okay, you are fine, right? I love you, sir. Strength. Well done. Okay, I will explain that thing back. Let me go over it again.
And please, also those missing values, because you kept on putting 99 in those three different boxes.
You were not following. You were not following me. Okay, I will explain. Don't worry. What I said is that look at it. By default, you have to go and click. By default, it says known. Can you see? You know,
yes.
When you type the name of variable here, the expector just gives you some default. Which they feel to be the common reason. That's why they put it there. The most likely default value. But you are at liberty to change it to suit your own. But if you're okay with it, you leave it. So you get it now. Like for this missing value now, me, I don't use missing value. That's why I say known. It doesn't mean that you have no response in your decision, because after all, no response is a function of when you are collecting the data. Either you have the question or the person answer or not, whatever. Or maybe the actual question is applicable, like what Dr. Tawu said. But here, this one gives you the liberty. You don't want to code non-response. That is none. But if you want to, there are other options. What I'm saying is that you may want to code all your missing value, all those non-response. There are, and they give you three options. They give you three. If you say you want to discrete missing value, that is, discrete here mean that you have a value you want to put in. The other one, that range, you want to give a range. But this one is usually used more. Now, this what I explained here is that you may decide to say, okay, my missing value, I want to put 99 there. But I have to be sure that that 99 is outside the range of possible value for that variable. Like if I'm doing for age now, I have to be sure that nobody is up to 99. Nobody's above 99, up to or above 99. If there is, I may use other figure, maybe 999 or 222, any outrageous figure.
Okay.
That's what I just mean. Now, you can decide to use, but the SPSS gave you three options, because you may have three different reasons for missing value. Not applicable, non-response, I don't know. So, you can quote the different reasons for a particular missing value. Say, okay, if it is, I don't know, this is what I'll put there. If it is not applicable, this is what I'll put there. If it's maybe it just happened that we don't even know the reason, just this is what I'll put there.
Okay, so this. Okay, so to understand what you're saying, so if the reason is not applicable, let's say we decide to put 99999.
Yes, so, I can put 999. Yes. It's you that will know. It's not that you. Then, it's you that will know that that is the reason.
I know, sir. Then if the reason is I don't know, then I'll put.
Then you I'll use another one. You may say if not applicable 999. I may say I don't know 9994.
Okay, is that the next box?
Yeah, I can decide to say if there is any other reason. It doesn't, you don't need to exhaust it. If there's any other reason, I can put 995 of it.
Okay, so how would it now appear? So
if you appear like that also, it will what you do is that you put 9 when you are entering, you should have put it, not that it will appear there. It should have type it there. But the computer, when is you run the analysis, it will be conscious not to use it as calculation, whatever. It will be conscious that this is for missing value. It will not use it to compute anything. It's I don't know if you understand.
Yes.
Like
yes,
now, if you put it there, now when you are running your age, mean age, it will not tamper with it as to use to go and calculate your mean age. I don't know if you understand me now.
I understand.
Yes.
Then that would
if you go and put another, if you made mistake and put another figure outside the one you are designated as missing value, it will affect your study. Then if your missing value is within the range, maybe I put 99 now in the first one, I put 99, and there's someone that is up to 99. That person he will not calculate that person as a, he will calculate the person as a missing person. I don't know if you understand me. That is why you
okay, so that's what the range is for.
Outside the range of that, yes. Okay. But you decide, you may decide not to use the missing value. Yeah.
Maybe we should use an example.
Okay.
For that range.
Okay, don't worry. Somebody wants to ask a question. I will come back. Somebody want to ask a question in that regard?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
I'd like to ask a question.
Okay, sir.
Now, if we put 999 uh-huh. Uh-huh. As not applicable.
Uh-huh.
You know, when we're doing values, we are able to code it that one is male, two female. Now that 999 that I put, is there anywhere I can code it so that when I see that 99, I will just, apart from the one I've written, if the computer sees it, the computer will know that 99 means not applicable. Is there anything like that? Or we'll just put it in this box and leave it.
Just put it in the box you put in where you know what it means. It's you that you know what it means. Just give you option. It's you that you know. That's why sometimes it says you have code book. When you are doing your analysis, you have a code book. You know, code book means that what some of those things you put, what do they mean? I don't know if you understand. It's you that you know where you code, you know what it means.
Okay.
I think I've answered your question. Doctor, you say we should give an example. Okay, I've done this one as missing value now.
Please, what of the range?
Yes, this one is to, is like, it wants you to give a range. Instead of giving a district, it give a range low as, you give a particular value. So in that case now, any range you give, upper and lower, any range that falls within that is considered as missing. You understand me now? So, like for example, now I can decide to say between 100 and 200. So what I will do is that whenever there is missing value, I'll just type any number in between. But I'm sure that this number, those numbers, they are not part of, they are not within the range of my real data. So any data, any number, any value within this range will be considered as missing.
So what is the discrete value box? What is it for, sir?
Okay.
That box down there.
Okay. Let me just give. You just want to, where is it, Dixie? What is the difference between range and this discrete? The issue is that this one is just a value you can put, but you can see, you can seek accommodate value from as low as this and as high as this. This one just means this is the value you want to put. You want to put, but sometimes it can take any value between the low and the this. And the reason is that there may be many, just like the way we say there are many reasons for missing, but it may not be only one. You get it, man. But you can even look at it, there are two options now. You can decide to use this option. When you use this option of range is not applicable. And you see, if the option of range you are using, the discrete is not as applicable, then the first option is no missing value, which I usually use. But you can use missing value because especially it's good, especially when we are entering data, it's not you that will analyze it. Are we together? Okay.
Yes, now, we're fine, sir.
Yes. Welcome. I think I have explained column. This alignment, just like any alignment, right or left alignment, because when you enter it, the way it will show.
Please, sir. Sorry yes? to go. You said column. I didn't get your explanation for column.
I say you can compare. You know, there are two things that look like width and column. No, they yes. look alike because yes. it gives you different ages. I think width is the number of the character of the name that will appear in the computer when you type. That you see the character of the name, like age of participant. We will put age now. Is the first eight that will appear inside the computer. But with a column mean, when you say age, the figure I put there, I give an example that I even have long something like income. Now, if they say income, monthly income, the width is the word monthly income. How many of it will appear in the width? The figure you put in is the column. If you put in 1 million, so and so, if you put long something and you put in 9 digits and it's only 8 digits that will appear, you see. So you can increase it, just like the other one. You can decrease it. So most of them is just there are some of them, it's on rare occasion you need it. Some of those features, it's on rare occasion. You remember that these things they keep on improving. It was not like that before when they first created, but there are some rare occasion where they need something, they will not put the feature. You see some feature that you don't even need. Yeah, I'm just explaining. But sometimes you may need it also. So alignment. Alignment is just like any alignment. Is it right or left or middle? That's all. But you see something. Look at this sex now. Okay, no, let me use... let me use any sex. So we put numeric there, right? If we change it to string, look at it. If you see numeric... all of them, they are numeric. Look at it. All of them are right alignment. But let me change this text to string. You see what will happen. What happened to the alignment? Can you see?
Left.
It becomes left. Thank you. So by the way, if it is string, alignment will be left. If it is numeric, it will be... So the alignment change on its own. Well, you can change the alignment with your hand anyway also. It doesn't really matter. Change and just give you the default it will give you. So measure, this one very, very important. Measure, you see by default you say unknown. Unknown, what is the measure here? It's talking of the scale of measurement. Scale of measurement. I don't know, some of us that have been in the class, the previous class we did on all those the Tuesday, Thursday classes where I talk about the descriptive statistic. We talk about, basic concept of statistics. We talk about scale of measurement, nominal, ordinal, interval, and ratio. Look at it when you click. It gives you the three options. The scale means either interval or ratio. That is numerical. That's why it's this scale. That's why you even put measurement. Can you see the ruler? That is something you are measuring, numerical, scale. Ordinal means ordinal scale, ordinal scale, and this one step ladder, stage by stage. Nominal means there's no ranking. No, this ordinal that is ranked. Now that's why it's 6 step. But this one there's no ranking. All of them are the same as they put on the same plane. So it wants you to tell you the type of variable. So the serial number is just a serial number. Actually, the serial number is actually nominal. You are not using to to do anything, just a serial number. Group is nominal, either group one or group two. Age is scale, because scale. Sex is nominal. Marital status is nominal. That's the way you do it. Just do. The last one here is role. Which role is this one doing? Though there are some of these things they put there, I don't even know where they are for bed. Now, if you look at by default, you see input. Input just means it's one of the variables. But if the variable is for you to split, like for this group now, variable, because this group variable, for you to analyze it group by group, you can go and say split variable. Can you see? So there's some other partition. Maybe, I don't know what you have better. This one's a target. No.
Yes, I didn't get that split variable you talked about.
Like your work, that your work now you did, your work is Obanura, right?
Okay, yes.
You know, we have a variable which is the group that show group one, group two. And it's based on the group that you split them to analyze them into. You know, when you analyze it, you analyze group by group. You don't analyze them together. Every analysis you run separately for group one and group two, separately. Mm? So you may indicate ab initio that it's a group, it's a split variable here. That is to split the analysis into two, into whatever, it may not be two, whatever number of value that variable has. Yes, I'm not. But you can still leave it as simple because there's a place, when I told on that data, we can split. Can you see? Split five. Yeah. When you want to split, I can go and split there. So, because sometimes also a variable may not even be a split variable, you want to say, analyze male and female. Let's be separated from male and female. You can go here and split it. You don't need to come here. You can go here and split it. And when you finish, you return it back.
But so
somebody wants to say something. Yes?
I was just saying that even if we leave it as input, you know, when we analyze, there's a way we still go about it that it still gives us the separate when we cross tab.
That is what, that one is different. Cross tab is different. Cross tab is different. When you are cross tabulating, it's different from splitting. Okay, all when you split,
yes,
all your frequency table, they are in two, urban, rural, private, public. I don't know, you understand me now? If you split in constabulation, what did you do? You will do chi-square separately for each of them. You know, it's not comparative study you did. Yeah, we did chi-square separately for each of them.
Anything
you do, it will do it separately for the group. That is the meaning of splitting. Okay. And you can go here on that data to split and do that. We will do later. So okay. I think I've explained. So when you are creating your variable, that is what you do. When you create it now, before you ask, okay, I want to start entering data. You now go to data view. If you look at it, for variable view, the property characteristic of variable is along the column, vertical. But each variable is along the row like this. So if you have up to five now, with your serial number, that is you have five. If you just say your variable is up to 30, that's why you will be adding it, creating everything up to 30. I don't know if you understand me now. If your questionnaire is up to 30, it will be up to 100. You will now create it. So the line will be up to 100. You will explain the property characteristic of each variable. Does it make sense? So that is what we did for that BMI, that thing we opened. Now when you now finish, you now click on data view. You will see the variable when you were doing it is along the horizontal because the characteristic that is along the vertical. But the variable itself is along the but when you come to data view, they are along the vertical because what is along the horizontal is your case, that is the person, the subject you begin to enter. When you want to okay, the first person now, number one, you click number one. That's it, group. Oh, it's in group two. That's it, or group one. See, number one is in group one, group two. Depends on which one you enter first. Age of, as you can see, 70. No sex is male, which is one. Marital status is widow, which is five. You know? When you finish, you go to number two, you enter. So, you know, the variable, there will be plenty like that. That's how you enter it like that, up to the finish. So for one person, that person, everything but that person should be on that line to the end where the variable finish. If they are up to 100, that's how you see long. When you finish, number two, that's how you enter. That's how to enter data. So if your sample size is 400, that's how this will be up to number 400. That was what, if you look at, let me share this other one, the first one I opened. That was what we did here. Okay, I don't know. Any question in what we have just explained now? Question before we proceed. Any question? Because once
I didn't quite get the explanation for not using the system numbers. Why we have to create a new serial number?
Okay, thank you, sir. Okay. What I mean is that look at this number now. Can you see? There is a system number, there's your serial number here. You may think it's tally, but if you are, if you go and sort by another thing now, maybe I sort by sex now. We scatter the serial number. Can you see the serial number?
Okay.
The machine number is there, it's stable. The machine number does not go, if you run the analysis, the machine number one, well, you don't even need to run the other number anyway. But if you look at it by sorting it now, the machine number cannot locate what was number two before. It's no more number two. According to the machine, it has scattered. If I sort, or if you run the analysis, summer, you can scatter it. So if you didn't put this serial number as a variable, person will be lost. If there's a problem, maybe this is 65, now it's 6 they wrote. No, if it's 60 they wrote, I may not know if it is problem or not. But if it is 5 or 6, I know how can the weight be 5 kg adult. It's not possible. That must be a mistake. For me to track, is the serial number, I will not go number 5. The enter, anywhere it is, it appears. It will be number 39 that they had the problem. Because I've already written those numbering before I even enter. So if I enter according to the numbering, I can go and check number 35, if it's the eliminated one, and check the questionnaire and see where did I make mistake. Is it a mistake? What is the weight? Does it make sense, sir?
Yes, sir.
The machine number will not give you that. Do you get a vision? So if you remember,
I understand now.
When you enter serially, it appeared that okay, when you enter the machine, as if the serial number goes with the machine number in the line. If anything, any analysis, maybe you do some sorting, whatever, it will scatter the serial number. So the machine number does not guarantee you locating. If you have not serialized your questionnaire, how will you even locate? So you have to first of all serialize your questionnaire number and also enter the same number also. That's the only way you can get. Any other question?
All right, thank you, sir.
Dr. Taiwo, what do you say something? Okay, no problem.
No, what I want to say is that, hello, sir. Hello,
yes,
sir.
Yes, sir. I'm listening.
You know, initially, you know, when you are trying to create the variables,
yes, sir,
in the horizontal line, sometimes it may fall on one. Or the label that you put on top, the group, the age, the sex, you know, the former page that we, before we got to this page. So that number may fall on one if you don't create this one. No, when we're trying to create the.
Okay, it's the same thing. This one, just an example. So it's just like this one.
Yes. So that serial number may not follow the number one of the machine.
If
you don't create, that's your own serial number. Yeah, the machine serial number.
Another one, sir. This one is another thing. Another thing, sir.
Yes.
This serial number here is different from the serial number. The serial number on the variable view is different from the number on the data view. You understand me now?
Yes.
This number, for the variable, you may not even, the only thing, you may not even put serial number, if you look at it now, as you are typing this variable, you didn't put number. But sometimes you may put number, it depends. Yeah. You understand me now? Sometimes, okay, if some people have scatter questionnaire that are very complex, for to make it easier for the person that want to enter, you want the questionnaire and the file, the variable view, to be as close, what you type here, the variable name, to be as close as what is in on paper, so that the person will figure it, make it faster. You understand me now? So that's why we try to, if you put A, number one, put, this one is even expensive. If it is painful, if you don't arrange it, we rearrange it for you. That one is the problem with that one. But this one, if you don't even put, it arrange it the way they appear here for you. That's one thing with expensive.
Okay.
You arrange it. If you don't even put serial number for the question, I mean the question number one, question number two, that's what I mean. But the serial number I'm talking of is that when you are entering your data, the first person you enter, this questionnaire like this one, I'm not talking of the serial number on the question, then the questionnaire, this questionnaire from maybe from Bolanle, maybe this Bolanle that answered this question. So, number one. Then the one answered by Gabriel, number two. The one answered by Ushe, number three. I don't know if you understand me. You should be able to number. That's how we create a very serial number. So that, you first of all, for this one, for number one, before we start entering age or the other thing. So if there's any problem with our entering, we will see it when we are running the analysis. We're able to trace its number 30. I'm not looking for a question now. 30. Oh, this one is from Bausat. Actually, you may not need the name. I'm just giving an example that this questionnaire is for from somebody. So any other question?
Questionnaire one.
Yes. So it's good to, very, very important. It can mess up somebody's work. Completely mess up. Irredeemable. As simple as that. So I think we proceed, right? Now, I don't know.
Yes.
I think we have laid our hand on this. So what you do is that when you go back, try to practice, just open and practice. That's how to create those, very simple. And you start entering. And I will now go, open, I will try and open. I want somebody to open, share. I don't know, somebody to open and share that Excel I gave you. Yes, I mean that. Because the Excel also is very simple. Okay, somebody, I don't want, before you even go and open the Excel I gave you, let somebody click on Excel and share with us. Let me allow sharing. Because I want it to be participatory. Let me allow sharing. Uwe, Blossom, will you do that for us? Open an Excel outside Zoom and come on inside Zoom and click on share. When you now click on share, if you open, you will see the Excel, you double click on it. So I will tell you what to do. Blossom, are you there? I cannot hear you unless you unmute yourself. Blossom. It's not there. Okay. Where is Bridget? Ify. Ify. Okay. Taiwo, Dr. Taiwo is doing it.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes. That is it, Ify, that is answering me.
Okay.
Who is trying to share? Somebody is trying to share. Dr. Taiwo, you are trying to hear.
Yeah.
I'm trying it. I'm trying to do it.
Okay, okay.
So, can I ask a question while they're trying to do it?
Ask questions, sir.
So before you go to bring out that Excel, will you minimize the Zoom view?
You don't need to minimize. No, okay. It's just for you. No, you can. You cannot minimize the Zoom. Even when you are on Zoom, it will not allow you to minimize. But you can reduce the, you can reduce it to small or big. You cannot minimize. Minimize means to collapse it. It will not allow you. Zoom will not allow you to minimize when you are on Zoom. Yeah, but you can prevent full view. No view. So if you exceed full view, you'll be able to see your icon on the taskbar. Is the icon on the taskbar? Can you see if you are see, like now? I'm seeing the icon on the taskbar now.
Okay.
I don't know if you can see your own icon on the taskbar. So you'll be able to click on anything outside the Zoom.
Okay.
So I thought Dr. Tai was trying. He didn't try again. Didn't do.
I was signing. I wasn't.
So okay.
Now, I'm not using my laptop.
You have to first of all click on the Excel first. You have to first of all, it will open the Excel for you first. When it opens the Excel for you, you now come back to the Zoom. You will see under, you see share screen. You click on share screen. When you click on share screen, it will show you some things. You now look for the Excel. Excel is one of those things. It will show you what you have opened. Then double click on it. It will share. Everybody will see. Ify. Bridget.
Yes. Yes.
So you can. Have you opened your own Excel outside Zoom?
Yes.
You have done
yes,
that.
Yes, I've opened the Excel.
Uh-huh. What
I
do you do now?
I don't know how to import.
Don't worry. Just leave it. After you have opened now, come to Zoom now. Come into Zoom, in your Zoom. You will see.
Just one minute.
Okay.
Sorry, sir. How do we get the thumbnail to make this Zoom to be thumbnail, to be smaller? Where do we click?
There's a place, enter full screen at the left corner. If you don't want to enter full, it will, can you see the SC full screen? That's where you do it.
It's on the right side. Enter full screen.
I see full screen. Yes, it's here. You are seeing an icon on the right upper, this thing. If you do that, it will help you be able to see your icon. Like now, I see full screen now. I'll be able to see my icon on the on my laptop. But if I enter full screen, I won't be able to see my icon on the taskbar. Just a minute.
Okay.
Just a minute.
Okay, yes, so I've seen it.
Just a minute. Hello? I'm not in there. I started to have issue with the internet, so we're now started by 8. You have to come and bring the other one, yes. So, I'll call you when we finish. I was calling you like you were on transit by that time. Okay.
Just one question again. What if the icon is not on the taskbar now, how do you go and access it? Because I have Excel.
Very simple. No, your icon, if you look at it, on your taskbar, there is a place you can, taskbar is there, where you can click on, there's something like, beside your taskbar, something like a magnifying glass. I don't know how your own is. Where you can type Excel, E-X. To show you Excel.
Okay, yes.
Word. Show you what there, yes.
Okay.
So, you open the work or whatever. When you open it, you now come to Zoom, come back to Zoom, now go to share screen, you click on share screen, it will show you a lot of things, including that thing you now double click on that one, it will show us. Okay, I feel, come and do it now.
Okay, yes.
Go to share screen.
Yeah, it's okay.
So because all this is you need to do it. Once you do it, it's very simple. Ify, are you there? Ify. He's not answering me. Ify, are you there? Okay. Okay, Dr. Bako is doing it. Your share screen. Dr. Bako, it's me you are sharing.
Yes.
What you do is go back
yes,
to...
Yes, I'm surprised.
So it's not me. I'm not saying you share me.
See my
Excel. Yes. Excel, yes. No, don't stop sharing.
Has the Excel come up?
It's okay. We have seen it. Can everybody see the Excel? It's not me that share it. It's Dr. Bako that share now.
Yeah, you can see it. We can see. Thank you.
Yes. So you can see. It's very simple. So, Dr. Bako, if you go to the A number one and the first cell, Excel, if you look at it, the arrangement is like the SPSS. Excel is the most powerful package in the sense that it communicates, you can adapt it to anything. It's the one that communicates with SPSS, with Stata, with FINFO, with all the stuff. So that's why even if you don't know anything, somebody want to say, I want to my data. I say just put it in Excel. Just click Excel. Many people you are just put it in Excel. And send it to me direct. I will do it. I will do all the other cleaning and put it in SPSS. But some people cannot still put in Excel. They still want someone to help them create that in Excel. It's as bad as that. But the issue there is that it's very simple. The first row, you know, the SS is not customer like the SQS is now, because the SS is for many things, but the SQS is for that database and analysis. So the first row will be your variable. Just type the variable. Type serial number in that one, Dr. Serial number. You know, you can put SN. You may not type SN.
SN.
And just put SN so that you, instead of here, yeah, SN. Thank you. Move to the next one, type age. Move to the next one, type sex or group or whatever you want to type sex. Yeah, type marital status, type anything you want to type. Type height, type weight.
Any marital S will be good.
Yeah, And this one, you know, allow you to put spaces. You enter, it doesn't really matter. You can put space, you may not put space. It allows because, but when you enter this SQS, it will collapse it for you. If you put this SQS, if you collapse that it. That's right. See, so these are the variables. Yeah, type as many you want to type now. Heard of TV before? Heard of
income, TV. Income.
Income. Expenditure.
Anything that require yes or no, out of TB, out of TB.
Okay, yes or no. Okay, yes or no.
And the answer will be yes or no. You know, there are some questions that are yes or no. I will see out of TB, TB. So the list is endless. I will together now. Yes. The list is endless.
Yes.
So very simple. You now start your number press, you know, the only difference is that this one, you now start entering your data. Number one, you just put number one. You know, serial number, the person is number one, yeah? Now put the age, put the age now.
Okay. Put the sex. 45,
you,
sex.
Put this one, yeah?
Group one. Sex. If it's male.
Then you can type, you know, let me tell you something.
Type the male.
No, type the male. Let me tell you something about... For you not to make mistake when you are entering with SN, it is better not to code. Don't code. You are likely to make mistake. If you code one, before you know, you can even go and type the view, you will be confused. You don't know what the confusion bet.
I have a question.
Okay.
Are you saying now that if we can fill it into Excel, it will convert it to SPSS information?
You will see now. That Excel I gave you, that the database, you are going to enter into SPSS, you go to see. I just want us to see how you enter in Excel first. That Excel, the one you are sent to you, somebody will ask somebody to go and open it. We are going to open it in SPSS now. And you will now save it as SPSS. And that's just for you to do some minor changes in all those properties. Now put it. And another just put it. Even the funnest thing, even the SPSS has to do something.
You have like two. Let's do two.
Put single. You see something that will happen. Put S, you see.
Okay.
Now, that's what I wanted to explain. Whenever in Excel, if you have typed something, if you have typed something before, when the next one, put the first number, it just appear, just say enter. It just move ahead. So you make it faster, and you are not likely to make mistake. You enter the way it is. Don't worry, by the time you send it to SPSS, there's a way we clean it. We remove the figure. You just put the figure there. You know, you can just put the figure there and go and label it. You can sort it. When you get to SPSS, just sort it and say single one. You put it. Marry two. We paste all the two there. So when you are entering with Excel, it's easier for you, it's faster, and you're not likely to make mistake if you try to type those things there the way they are. Because the only thing that if you see separated, if you by the time you type separated, if you now put S, it will not give you single on SI. Because S separated is already typed there, single, both of them start with S. Until you put something that separates them. So if you want to type separated, you put SA, separated will come up. SI, single will come up. Because you have two that start with S. I don't know if you understand now. If the other thing that there's no repetition, it's only that one, okay. Like marriage, it's only him. That's only him. I should put M. It's the same thing, male and female. Put M, may come up. That is way to handle the entire world. Does it make sense? So, someone who does not waste much time.
We are understanding it, so it's very good.
Okay, thank you. The same even with the all these yes or no. Once you have put yes before, the remaining one will appear to you. Just be entering it. You are not likely to make mistakes. Okay, I think what we'll do now, thank you, Dr. Bako, you can stop sharing. So please, I want, when I ask you to share, please share. I don't want to even do the talking alone. I want it to be co-facilitation. It's adult learning. It's facilitation. I'm not a teacher, I'm a facilitator. You get a vision, I want to facilitate your understanding. You know, there was a time I sent my flyer, my this thing to public department in Gwagalada. So one of my colleagues here now says, okay, this TO, they make they will give me feedback too. Some people are just wondering, what is the feedback? It's okay, I'm open to all this. I don't know. They said that some of the topics are not statistic, the epidemiology, and the way I arrange them also. You know, who is that person that is talking? The person doesn't know me. Is it this person saying no? They don't know me. Only they are talking as lecturer. Me, I'm a facilitator. You are a teacher. Your lecturer, most lecturer confuse people. When you confuse people, you go and be rattling. But me, I facilitate your understanding. You know, like now before. You in my statistic class now, before I talk about sample size, even sample size at all, I want to talk to you about sample size. I will have finished with p-value with you because you will discover that power, p-value, they are there. Level of significance, confidence level, they are there in calculating sample size. So I will have explained the logic behind that topic before. So that it's not just to give topic, to give lecture, it's to give facilitate your understanding. And that is why I would like to go systematically. Okay, don't let us waste time on that. I want somebody to share the skin lesion, the Excel I gave to Ross. The way you're going to share it, okay, share it first. Let somebody share it first. Let's look at it. Then we are going to read it. Another person will read it through SPSS. Who will share? You may not necessarily have a Dr. Judith. And who say? Can you open your? Okay, have I sent it to you? Okay, you cannot because you send your this thing late, your email late. I couldn't email it to you because it was late. I will mail it later. Okay, who has the Excel? Who will share with us? Let me call another person. Dr. Shewade. Yes. Open the essay. Share the essay. Even you may not even. Okay, that's great. That's great.
Somebody
sharing. Yes, sir. So is this Dr. Wale that shared this one?
No, this is Dr. another person.
What's the name?
Aisha Bello. Omolola.
Okay, Aisha. Okay, Aisha Bello. Okay, that's great. That's great. Yes. Can we see? You can enable your this thing. Okay, leave that one. Can you see? You see what we just demonstrated now? See that number eight and just enter. That is where you enter. That's where you enter. It's as simple as that. The only thing is that you have different type of variable. All this one that you have numeric. This one, we've already coded it here. But sometimes, why I ask you in entering not to code it is to minimize mistake and make it faster. And it's within few minutes, even on Excel, you can change it back. It's just a matter of sorting and change it to the figure. You know, changing it from letter to figure is not difficult in Excel. But entering data is the difficulty. And if you are entry figure, you are likely to make mistake. No, you are likely to make more mistake when you are entering the figure. So that's why you enter the way it is. Later we can change it. Okay. Now,
hello, sir.
You, Dr. Taiwo,
hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
From this exam, now if you look at the way the variables enter, so the serial number, our serial number does not correspond with the
machine's number. Yes, it will not. Yes, it will not, because the first, okay, thank you. I wanted to say it before. That's a very good observation. Now, you know the first row is your variable. Even when you want to, you will see, when you want to read it, when you want to read it in SPSS now, you will say the first row is for variable. So the second row, that's where you start from. So your serial number will be one shot of the number of the other one. You understand me? Of the number of the machine. So it doesn't really matter. So, but the issue there, even the serial number can scatter, because it can scatter. When you sort according to before you are, it can scatter. And if it scatters, save you. That is why the serial number is for you to have it. So it doesn't really matter. That is a very good observation. So that sometimes when you are looking at it, you know that it will be, there's a one difference of one. Okay, Dr. Bello, you can stop sharing. Who we now, who has SPSS? Who has SPSS? And as the, you have SPSS, you also have that skin lesion, the one Dr. Bello just, the file, the Excel file. Who do that? Dr. Blossom. Okay, you don't have SPSS for now. And when is Dr. Ify? Dr. Bidget.
Yes. Yeah.
I asked you to do something you have not done it to. It's another person that did it to. So have you clicked on your SPSS? Click on your SPSS outside Zoom.
I'm still having a problem with my listing. It's just coming on and off.
Okay, sorry for that. Please, you have to fix
on my SPSS outside Zoom.
Yes, yes, do it. If it open, just open that. It's open the way it opened the first for me the other time. Just open, just click on it. Like just open it. It has opened. So I think somebody's is echoing. Godwin Michael is the one that. Let me move that. Is Godwin Michael computer?
No. No, it's me. Not my. I'm still the one.
Okay, it's your computer that is giving the noise, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Who is Godwin Michael? Who is Godwin Michael? I want to be sure I know everybody, because who is Godwin Michael?
It's my son. It's yes? My son.
Okay, it's you that you are connecting with the two, right? Okay, no problem. I can see that you are using iPad. Okay, no problem. If you have a problem, don't worry. Let another person help us do it. Dr. Anyaku. Dr. Ikechukwu. Okay, your SPSS is there right now.
Yes, I have my SPSS, but I don't have the lesion.
Okay, I have not sent it to you. I didn't send it to you. I didn't send the data for practice to you.
No, I've just checked my mail. It's not there.
Ah, sorry for that. I thought I will send it immediately after this. I can even send it now. I'm very sorry.
Okay, I've also not received it, sir.
You know, you are a facilitator, so that's why you... I thought you have it before. Okay, you were not around. Okay, I will send it to you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
I will forward it
down. Can I ask a question?
Ask a question, please. Ask your question.
How this SPSS that you sent to us through Gmail. Now, what's the relationship with Google Drive?
Hello?
Because I tried to open my own, say file not found.
Don't worry. The one I have sent to you, I have an issue with that. You know, people were downloading the other time and they were getting it. But somehow, because it's a is like a place, like a library where people, is a room where you people have access to. I just link it with you. So some people have corrupted it. So it's no more, just leave that one. I have to go to town to go and install nothing on my system and scan the system. And now somebody now gave me version 25, which I was tired to upload. It was a little bit, no internet was giving me problem today. So it was not uploading before we started. So after the, after this something, I will upload it. I will send it to you. I will resend it. You'll be able to get it. So, and most of the time, if you don't have Gmail, it, you know, you won't be able to download because Yahoo cannot download that heavy
I'm trying to open it with Gmail.
So, I don't know because I just have people. I don't want that some people that are ready to do this. I want it to be participatory. I don't want people to be redundant. Okay, Dr. Bako. Dr. Bako. Dr. Bako, unmute yourself if you want to. I may not hear you. Dr. Bako, maybe he's not there. You know, some of you, when you want to go and take off, you remove your picture, you remove your video so that you won't know that. Okay, so Dr. Bako is here. Yes, it's SPSS now. Okay. Ah, so fast. I don't want you to. You have gone to read it in SPSS, right? Dr. Bako? Dr. Bako? Unshare. Stop sharing. I want people to see the way you do it.
Okay.
Yes. I want people to do it. So, I want you, what I want you first of all to first of all show the SP, when you click on the SP before you enter it, when you click on it, just share that one with us. That's what I want. I want to start from there. I want people to see it. Everything we do is open. When you click on your SPSS, when it open the window like that, before you look for anything, just share with us.
And hope that's not too much for me to do. Let me try it.
Okay.
I hope it's not too much for me to do. Let me try.
It's not that it's not willing. I think he's trying to do it. You know why I'm doing this? I don't want to do it. You understand me now? It's a part of the learning. Do it. I'm demonstrating.
Share.
Because when you demonstrate, I'm just be talking to the ear. You will not pick anything. By the time you want to do, you see the difficulty in doing it. That is part of the learning. Learning it. Dr. Bako, are you? It's just for you to show all the SPSS you open and just the SPSS, just the icon. As you click on the icon, you just open before you open it. You just open the icon. That's what I want you to share with us. I think Dr. Taiwo, you have your SPSS also, right? Dr. Taiwo.
No, I have a problem with my laptop, so I'm just fixing it. I'm just fixing it.
You said it before. So
I have.
You said it before, don't worry. You said it before. I forgot.
Yes.
Dr. Bello. Not Bello. Okay, Aisha Bello. Dr. Aisha Bello. Why is Dr. Lola? Okay, Dr. Lola Bello is there. Is Dr. Lola, who shared it before? Was it Dr. Lola Bello that shared or Dr. Aisha Bello that shared? I share the Excel with us. If you want to talk, unmute yourself, please.
It was Aisha that shared with us now.
I shared earlier. Yeah.
That shared with us the other time. Okay.
Yes.
Doctor, okay. You have your SPSS now. Have you opened your SPSS?
Myself.
Have you opened? Click on your SPSS.
Are you referring to Aisha, please?
Yes, Aisha, yes.
Yes, it's opened.
Okay, now come to Zoom now and share on Zoom. Come to share Zoom and click on share. When you click on share, you now double click on the SPSS inside it. Double click on the SPSS and it will share. Yes, great.
So, done.
This is not SPSS. So, this is Excel.
Okay.
Please don't unshare this one. SPSS, have you clicked on your SPSS? Have you opened your SPSS?
Okay. Oh, sorry. Now I understand. My SPSS. Okay. Let me
see. Oh, yeah. Stop sharing this one. Stop sharing.
Okay.
Yes. What I want you to do, click on your SPSS.
All right.
You know why I'm doing this one? By saying that everybody is learning. The mistake somebody make, you may likely make it, so you learn. You won't make that mistake. When you click on your SPSS, once it just open, don't go and open. Just once you just open the icon, you see that it opened the something. Before you go inside. Open. Okay, now come to Zoom now. Come to Zoom. Click on the share screen.
I'm sure it's taking some time. It has not.
Okay. Okay. Yeah. Who has SPSS there? Okay. Dr. Shewadi has none.
I have.
Dr. Who say he has?
I have.
That is who? What's your name?
Ifoma. I'm using my son's okay, iPad. Yes. God willing, you did that.
iPad cannot do the work. Okay, this is computer now. This Godwin is computer, right?
Okay, let me try.
This Godwin. Okay.
Yeah. Yes, it's laptop. Laptop.
Yes, okay, that's great. Great, yes, that's what I want to do.
Been there now.
Yes, it's there. Now, you are in SPSS now. Now, go to file. You know where you save that skin lesion? That skin lesion, that excess skin lesion, you know where you save it to your computer, right?
If I go to file, which one do I, is it new or open or import data?
Open, it's not new. Open. Open means that the thing is already existing. Open, and go open to data.
Data. Data.
Data. Yes.
Okay.
Click on the data. Click on the data.
So what do I click?
On the data now. Yes.
Do I go to file type?
Yeah, hey, wait. Before you go to file type.
I've clicked on it now.
I've seen it. We have seen it. Now, yeah. you know where you save that skin. Okay, this is where you save the skin lesion because I can see. No, where did you save the skin lesion? It's on that Zoom, Abby. Where did you save the skin lesion file? The one I sent to you. You don't know.
I think it's documents.
Look, go to the look for
documents.
Okay, yes. Now click
that
on that
skin lesion here.
Okay, yeah, down. Thank you. Wait. Look at what she did first for did. Go back, remove that Excel. I want people because it's a process of learning. Go back to where you remove that Excel and put the SPSS. You know. Go back.
I should
remove. Put that arrow. Remove that Excel. Go to SPSS. The what was there by default.
In your files of type. Yes.
File type. Click on that. Yes. Okay. Wait. Now.
Remove
what is the yes? Can you see what is doing your hand? Wait.
File type. Okay.
Wait. Don't do anything now. Everybody is seeing now. When you open, don't click on empty again yet. Just wait. I want to explain something. I want to explain something to people. If you look at it, by default, because it's in SPSS, by default, file type is SPSS statistics, you see there. The Excel is inside that folder, but you will not be able to see it because you cannot see Excel. So for her to recognize that Excel inside that folder where that Excel is, you have to now click on this file type and now click on Excel. Click on it now. Yeah, do it now.
That box, is it a box with Excel box?
Yes, man. Inside that thing, they are arrow down, you click on the Excel. It's no more with us. If he be doing something else. Did somebody say?
Yeah, inside this box.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Wait. Can you see now?
Yes.
Immediately.
Yes.
Yes.
I can hear you.
Yes, I'm explaining something.
Hello?
I'm hearing you.
Hello?
I'm hearing you. We can hear you. Everybody is hearing you. So, I'm just explaining something. Immediately, she click on the chair. You can see the lesion. That is the same that came up. Now click on it now and now read. Click on that skin lesion now. Click on the skin lesion.
At the top box.
And click on it and open it. The skin lesion. You have to click on it. Okay, maybe I should go and do it. You see, the issue is, some people are not pissed off. Is it that some people are tired? Some people are saying, you know, since we stopped late, we started late, we have to burn our time. Is it not so?
We're enjoying it.
I know some people are.
We're here.
Maybe they have something doing. Okay, let me do it. Let me do what I want her to do. Let me do it. Let me do it. So, this is, I'm in SPSS. I want to go and read that skin lesion, right? So, I will now go to file, open, data. It takes me to...
Network is very bad.
Okay, sorry. You can hear me now. I can understand. That was the problem I was having before. So now that skin lesion is inside this place, so because that's where I put it. But because by default, file type is SPSS statistic, it's only SPSS we can see. So I have to now click on the arrow beside that file type. This arrow, let me put this arrow. When I click on it now, I will now look for Excel. Can you see? Immediately I click on Excel, can you see all the Excel file count out? You cannot see the SPSS again.
We are seeing.
I now click on the skin lesion and now open it. When you open the skin lesion, the first thing Dr. Taiwo was saying, Dr. Akintemi was saying something that the first line, you know, the first line, the first row is for the variable. You start entering from second row. So you see, you say, read variable name from the first row of data. Can you see Mark is shaky? He check it. Can you see? He say, okay. Worksheet, leave skin lesion. Worksheet 1A to, it will tell you the number, the location in that Excel. You know, Excel is in column and row, and its number, the column is A, B, C, the row is 1, 2, 3. So it says 1A to H151 is telling you the total area where those your data is. Just telling you, just say okay. Can you see? It has read it in SPSS now. Can you see? The skin lesion has come. Can you see in SPSS? It's amazing. By nature, it just puts them string and numeric. If you want to change it. So if you look at it, if you want to now put value, you can put value. You can now begin to customize it. If you go to the data view, can you see? Does it make sense? So I can now save it. What do you
say? In other words, so it has imported it from the Excel, or it has shown it
imported it has imported it from Excel into SPSS. But you need to save it as SPSS. You now go to file and say save as. You now give it a name. You now, I've already saved it also here because I'm using it for demonstration of my computer. If it were to be your computer, it will not be there. I cannot say skin lesion to skin lesion. I can say the same name, or you want to change the name. And I say save. It is as now save as. But the Excel is still there inside of this thing, but it has saved this one as the SPSS. So you can do your, if you want to change anything, make it stay, somehow, even the SPSS will think this one should be nominal, this one should be scale, you even do it for you. But if there's other things it has not done for you, now do it. It was if it was.
Excuse me, sir. Please, can you do it again? Because I was disconnected, yes. So I didn't know how you imported from Excel to SPSS.
I will do it again. I will do it again. Okay, who was talking?
My network is very unstable.
Okay, is it Judy that is talking? Judy. No. Okay, no, it's not Judy. It's Ify that is talking. Judith. Dr. Judith. No. Dr. Judith. I want people to participate. Are you following us? Are you following us?
The network is very unstable.
One.
Eh? I know. I mean, I say, are you following? Because sometimes I say, you know, it's the internet. You are following.
I'm very naive.
Don't worry. You will get to know it. He says it's very naive. Don't worry. You get to know everything.
Yes.
Okay. What a blessing. Okay, thank you.
I'm following.
And we have a demonstration on how to speed the data and analyze. I don't see the Dr. Bako. Yeah, I wasn't. You have to, don't worry. No, you have already known the other one. Don't worry, you get it.
All right.
Yes, sir.
And you know, in a class, it's like that. Yes. So I want you, what a blossom. I like to carry people along. Mind you, even if you think you know some other thing, in the process of carrying other people, you get to know more things also. So,
oh, I actually learned a lot, sir. Yeah, I learned a lot, honestly.
I know that you want to play. Don't worry, we'll do it. There is time. Don't worry. We'll do it. So, Blossom, you are not talking. I don't like people that are not participating. Blossom, unmute yourself and talk. On the chat. Okay. Okay. Let me repeat it. Are you there now, Ify? Are you there now? Ify, are you there? He's out again. Someone that says I should repeat, demonstrate again.
Yes, yes.
Are you there now? Okay, let me repeat.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, I am.
Uh-huh. What I did is, I went to my SPSS.
My network is unstable.
Yeah, I went to my SPSS. From what you did the other time, even the existing one that you have opened, you can open another file through it. It's just for you to go to file. That's what I'm doing now. Even the existing one I've opened before. Go to file and then say,
yes.
Just like what you did, go to open data. Because I've opened data here recently, that's why it goes directly there. Normally, it will take you round, you know, you look for where it is. When you get, you look for where it is in your computer. If you get to that folder where that Excel is, you will not see it with your eyes. Because it's not the file type. Because the file type you can see here is SPSS file type. So you now go click on this arrow. Let me show the note here. I like spotting it. Click on this arrow and now look for Excel because it's Excel you want to look for. Now look for file type Excel. Immediately you click on Excel, all the Excel in that folder will appear. Every other thing will disappear. The idea is because you cannot see it. Can you see all the, it's the same folder, but all the Excel you cannot see, you cannot visualize, but you can see the Excel. So you now click on what you are looking for, skin lesion. As you click on it, it will give you this alert that read variable name from the first row of data. This is what I was explaining to Dr. Taiwo the other time. The variable name is on the first row. So it's by default, it will check it. And I'll tell you, okay, wash it. Just tell you your skin lesion is on this wash it. This is from cell this to cell this. You always just to say, okay. As you click okay, it has opened it for you. Does it make sense? Dr. Ify.
Yes.
So I think we
make sense.
Yes. Mm-hmm. So that is how to export from Excel. So you will now save it as SPSS. Save if you don't spell it, you now save it as SPSS. When you save it, you have a copy as SPSS. The Excel copy is still there in your computer.
Oh, interesting.
So you now save it. Your SPSS, you now can make your what you are supposed to make the amendment, no clean it, all those stuff. That's all. That's how to import. Any other question on that? So that I can move ahead as Dr. Bako said. Any other question on that? So, the logic behind creating variable entry data, entry in Excel, also importing, I think we are done with that. So, the person that very anxious, that's Dr. Bako. Dr. Bako?
Yes, sir.
Now, share your skin lesion with us now, the SPSS one. If you have not saved the assessment, you can see. If you can see, go and open the open as Excel and ask the assessment. Let's work on it. Let's start doing all those things. All those things. I'm going to be doing
all right. Let me.
Can you use
it?
You can use cable.
I'm not sure. Dr. Moronike.
If you want me to hear you, unmute yourself. Dr. Moronike.
Sir.
Are you there? That's why yes, I like seeing people's face, because when people want to go and go to the room to take something, they just remove their video. So we don't know if they are there. Are you following?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you sure? Don't worry. Yes, between tomorrow, today, and before tomorrow's lesson, we sort out all those technical issues. So,
okay, sir.
Don't worry. When you talk it out, you will be the one running the analysis tomorrow.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Dr. Lola?
Sir, are you seeing the SPSS skill lesion, sir?
No, SPSS, that's what the Dr. Bako has shared now. Yes.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, that's what Dr. Bako has shared, yes.
Yes, sir.
Now, that's great. So we want to, first of all, do something.
Yes, sir.
Have you saved it as SPSS?
Yes, it is in SPSS.
Okay, that's great. So, you may want to go, first of all, run frequency. You want to know the frequency. That's the way to explore. You know what? I want to delete something from this file because I've used this file for demonstration. In fact, that's the oldest file I use for demonstration. You understand me? This oldest file. That's why you see some things there. Those CD4 can log. Or from B8, let me delete them. You can go to,
from this
if
one.
You want to make it easy to delete, you can even go to variable view. Okay, you can delete from here also. Delete.
Yes. Delete it like this. Sir.
Yes, right click and delete. Right click.
Clear.
Yes, done. Thank you. And save. Yes. Control S. And save, yeah. Thank you.
Yes. Yes. Thank you, sir.
This is at the original data. Okay, now go to analyze. Want to start running some? Go to analyze. Go to
I'm there, sir.
Descriptive. Descriptive.
Yes, sir.
Frequency.
Right.
Click on frequency. Click on it.
Yes.
Now, it gives you it. Yeah. If you want to, instead of picking each of them, just Control A, it is copy, select all. Control A, move, just click on the arrow. Yeah,
it's done. It's done. Everything.
Yeah. Don't move. Yeah, return the S, serial number. You don't need that one. Return that serial number. That one, you are not analyzing it. You return. So click OK. Click OK.
All right. Great.
Yes, thank God. It's even, everything your computer is powerful. It has good RAM. It's even showing us the. So if you don't have good RAM, sometimes I don't know why it will not show the output for you. You have to go and share it. And you see now, we are seeing the output. If you scroll down and you see the output, you need to scroll down, you see the output of the A, the sex, the marital status, yes, but you will see something. Yeah. You will see
the CD4 count.
Exactly. Yes, you will see that those ones that are quantitative variables. They are long.
Yeah.
The ones that are very categorical long. Variable, they are manageable numbers.
Yeah. That is the nature. Especially like the sex.
Thank you. So, sex, marital status, either situation, yes or no, they are manageable. You can just copy this thing and go and transfer it to your table, in your world, in your resort.
Three of them.
The percentage and everything, just put it. No? So, not that you go and copy and paste it. Even if you copy and paste, draw table in the world separately and transfer them to make it neat. Some people go and copy directly. The table will not be the best. What I'm just saying that the result is transfer the way they have into the table. That is the nature of categorical variable. But quantitative variable, because there are infinite number of possible value, you get a vision. So it will list all of them. The only way that can make you, if you want to tabulate it, is to arrange it. Are we following now? So if you remember, some of you that have listened to my lecture on descriptive statistics, you summarize the categorical variable with percentage. That's proportion, right? And that is what the computer has given us through frequency table, proportion. You just put it. We know that female is 63.3%, male is 36.7%. That's summary of sex. Marital status, their percentage is their summary. The single nation, their percentage is their summary. That's summarizing categorical variable. But if we want to summarize quantitative variable, we are going to calculate the mean, mode, median, range, whatever, for all those category quantitative variables like age, CD4 count, and viral load. But see, even when you do that, you may still need to tabulate. That's where you arrange. So what I want to first of all do now, before we come and arrange age, is to first of all, we are seeing the frequency generally now. This frequency has shown us, it will summarize everything about categorical variables. But it has not given you the summary of quantitative variables. If you want to summarize quantitative variables, go to analyze Dr.
Yes, sir.
Bako, yes. Analyze.
Yes, sir.
Then.
Analyze here again.
Yes. Go to descriptive. Now look at descriptive.
Descriptive.
Look at descriptive. Yes. Click on descriptive. Yes, sir. Yes. You see, put those age. CD4 count,
yes,
and viral load. Those are the count
in viral load.
Let me tell you something. If let's say you have not coded all those other variables like sales, marital status, skillation, you have not used numeric, you have not used number. When you come to this description, it will not even appear in this dialog box. You will not see it.
Okay.
It will not be visible. It's visible because it's numeric you put in. Of course, you put in a numeric doesn't mean that they are scale variable.
Numeric.
They are not scale variable. That's why, can you see the one that are scale variable? You remember when we were putting it at the measure, the scale, we have already put them at scale. Can you see? You see they are assigned. Now, you can come to option here. Click on option, doctor. Can you see by default, it put mean, standardization, minimum, maximum. If you still need more, you can put it, but just leave it like that. I just want you to know.
Yeah.
If you don't even want to know the sum, you know, sum. You know how do you calculate the mean?
Yeah.
Sum over the total number, if you want to know.
That's right. Leave that That's one. Right.
Click on continue. Click OK.
OK.
Scroll down. Can you see? This is this. Can you see now? It gives you the minimum, maximum, mean, mode. But if you look at, there's no median here. There's no mode there. I just want to take you to where you will see all these things. Is everybody following? Now go to analyze again. If it's only mean and standardization you need for that thing, this one is enough for you. Let's go to frequency. Go to frequency. Return all those other ones that sex, return sex.
Sex, marital status, skin lesions.
Uh-huh. I want only the quantitative you are looking for. Now, go to statistics. Can you see them now? Me, okay, media,
yes,
everything. Okay, click on that's me, right. Media. If you want to know mode,
media mode.
You can leave mode. Nobody even use mode. What if you want to standard deviation, minimum, maximum, range, anything? Standard error of me. Want to need quarter? Because sometimes when if something is skewed, if somebody is skewed, they say that you should not use. You know, if it's not skewed, it's normally distributed. Use mean and standard deviation. But if it's skewed, say use media and interquartering. Because of that, you click on quarter. It will give you the upper and lower quarter so that you'll be able to do the interquartering. Okay, you can click continue.
Mm-hmm.
Continue, doctor. Now, remove this display frequency. If you don't put it, if you still go and do all those frequency for you, all those long frequencies, thank you.
Okay.
You got it now. So I want you to
follow
practically. So if you didn't remove that now, if you first run those long frequencies before you come to it, so it will show this one, so we also run the long frequency for you. We don't need that one. So, can you see now? For A, mean, standard error of mean, median, range, you can see percentile. So the 5th percentile, 70. So if you ask for interquartile, it will be between 25 and 75. If you say 28.75 to 36, that is the interquartile range. So that is the range between lower and upper quarter. That is where.
Hello, sir. Sorry.
Yes.
Sorry, sir. Hello, sir.
I'm listening, sir.
Sir. Thank you, sir. Yeah? Sorry, sir. I didn't get what you said about the interquartile range.
Okay.
Interquartile range.
What I said that later we are going to test for normality. You know, if something is not normally distributed, if the mean and median, the value vary, that is, if something is skewed, the mean and median will not be the same or will not be close. So in that case, if something is normally distributed, usually quote the mean plus or minus standard deviation. But if it's not normally distributed, he advises you to quote the median. Even after quoting the mean, also quote the median and the interquartile. What it does is that because the interquartile range remove the outlier because it's giving you 20. Don't worry, I will explain it further. There's still a lot of things I will show you. So whenever something is skewed, when you choose media, you quote interquartile as the measure of variability. If you quote mean, you quote the standard deviation as the measure of variability. That's what I just said. Okay.
Okay,
I don't know.
Okay,
Dr. Bako?
Yes, sir.
Stop sharing. I want to ask question. If anybody ask question, because I want people to participate. I want question. Because we are going to explore. We still go to see more of that thing. Dr. Aisha Bello.
Yes, doctor.
Any question is well understood?
I'm following, sir. Yeah.
Dr. Lolly Aisha has gone. What happened? Dr. Moronike. Dr. Moronike. He's not there. If you want to talk, you unmute yourself. I will not hear you unless you unmute yourself. He's not there. Oh, Dr. Judith is there.
Yes, sir. I am. Okay.
Do you, you know, sometimes, do you follow what I just explained? And are you following? Dr. Judy, are you following? If you are not following, ask question. If you have a question.
Not entirely. There are a few times.
Speak loud. You said that I was.
The question will drag a lot of us. But what I may request for, I don't know if it is possible, I that if I settle down, listen to this your play.
Oh, I shall share it. I share with you.
Play back.
No problem. I will do that. But the problem I usually have is that attaching it sometimes.
Help. When I listen.
Okay, I will share it. I will share with you. But it's good for you to understand why you are here also.
If
you are following, it's good to understand why you are here. You don't need to, like this one and like this one.
Everything.
Okay. Okay, no problem. What of Dr. Blossom? Dr. Blossom, are you there? Dr. Blossom? If you want to talk, you have to unmute yourself. Okay. Okay, let's continue. I don't want it to be a male-dominated class because it's already becoming that. After all, they are dominating our politics. I don't know why. I don't want them to dominate the class. Okay, let's proceed. So no,
okay.
You're laughing. Okay. Don't worry. Because some of the lady also, because issue of the data and issue of the SPSS. No, by tomorrow they cannot escape it. By the time they have the SPSS fees, they cannot escape it. Dr. Judith is out again. Dr. Lola, you are welcome. No, Dr. Bridget is out again. Okay, Dr. Bello.
I'm out, I'm here.
Yes, sir.
Okay, we have two Bello, yeah. But Lola Bello, I did see you the other time. So I will request, I want to see faces, so because I want to be sure there is no ghost that is attending the class. At least you show your face for 1 second. Let me see. Then you can hide it. Because I landed, you say that the face consumed data. That's why people...
So I'm here.
Yes, I like to see your face even for a second. So that we know there is no ghost that we are talking to. Okay. Now, Dr. Bako. Dr. Bako, share again. Go back to that so that we want to explore more. Yes, Google, Dr. Ogo, fine. That's great. You want to share again, Dr. Bako? Share that. Go back to that place so that we can see and demonstrate again. We want to explore the more. Yes. Sorry, I kept you late today. Not because of that, you will have finished now. Sorry. Tomorrow. Okay, that's great. So, at least after a while, you can write back. At least we can see, can be assured now. Okay. And sometimes also, it helps us to, because some people, they go and take, they are going to the kitchen, they are eating chocolate, they are doing other things. And that's why I usually recall them. So, since it's only the letter that we are seeing. Okay, Dr. Bako, share again.
Yes, sir.
Share that where you were before. Just share. Okay. I want us to go around.
The output.
You know, either the output, you can access it through the output anywhere. And with the output, because we can see access it through the output. Also. Share the output. I can see access the analysis. Share the output. Also. Share the output. I want to further do some exploration.
Are we there, sir?
Okay. Okay.
We are not there yet.
We
have not shared it.
You have not shared. You have to go to share.
Okay.
You have to click something. Uh-huh. Yeah. We have shared, we are seeing now.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, that's great. Now,
yes.
I want us to explore that age. We want to do something by age. You know? Exploration. When you say explore, that's where you explore for normality. You get to know a lot of things. So I will just maybe before we explore for the age. Because by the time we start exploring for that age, okay, before we explore for the age, leave that one. You know, he has shown us something, Dr. Asho, the Bako has demonstrated something now. when we run the frequency, we're able to see that the categorical variable, yeah, category come out, and you can address it and put in your table. But the quantitative variable is not like that. Even when you go to summarize the quantitative variable with a mean, it doesn't mean that it gives you a table. Just so most of the time, people still want to create a table that will show the some of those quantitative variables. What you do now, you range it, like for example, now age now. You want to range the age. You want to range the age now. You have to, you know, there are something when you want to range quantitative variable, there are some standard categories. Like CD4 can now. There are standard categories how to classify CD4 can. You want to range your CD4 can based on that. Your viral load, you want to range both on that. Age, even though there's no one, but there are some clue. Like when you know the minimum age and maximum age, like now the minimum age here. Okay. Share the output, Dr. Bako. Let's see the minimum age. Share the output for us.
The output,
yeah, this is the output. What is the minimum age?
7.
18.
18.
The maximum 18. Is 56. So we may want to arrange our age less than 20 to 29, 30 to 39, 40 to 49, and 50 and above. 50 and above. So if you want to do, you should make up your mind how you want to arrange your age. So even in that article, Dr. Bako, you can see assess yes, anything you want to assess, even the anything you want to do. Either you are in the output view or yes. Now we want to look at it's only that thing that doesn't show transform. Transform does not show there. Because I don't want us to go back to analyze. So go back to please share the other one. Share the data editor. Thank you. Now we want to transform the age now. We want to arrange it into this. Go to transform. No problem. Okay. Okay, no problem, Hugo. Okay. Yes. Now, you want to recode into different variable, this option. Go to recode into different variable. Not compute. Record into not the same variable.
That one
is dangerous because if you record into the same variable, you lose the original variable. I don't even know, they are not supposed to put the option there at all. So record into different variables so that you have your record, the original variable.
You didn't tell him. I told him the trial mom was there. You did not tell him. I told him.
So, click on it, doctor.
Yeah.
Then, you now see, you now move age into that something. Move age inside. Can you see? If you look at the label up, it's saying numerical variable into output variable. So numerical arrow into what? So come to the name and name. Put name. Type the name of what you want to. You put age group. Put age group. No gap. It will not take gap. It will not take the gap from you. So what I actually do is that this G, I make it capital so that you know that it's age group. The G, capital. Yes. So it's under label that you can type whatever. You may label, you may not label. But it's under label you can type with space. You understand now? Now, after you have done that, click on change. You will see what will happen. Click on change. They change below. Can you see? You now move that age group to replace that question mark. That is, you are coding age into age group. So after you have done that, come to old and new values. Old and new values. Click on old and new values. So have you clear here? Now click on range. Range. Click on range. That is one way to do better. That range is the best. Range. Now you have to know, okay, 18 to 19. Put 18 through 19. Put 18. Because then the next one is 19 through 19, the second space. You don't want to do below 20. And because the smallest is 18, that's why I said, let's say the smallest is 10, I would say 10 to 19. It's just for me, you can even say 1 to 19 or 0 to 19. So far, it covers the smallest. You get it now, you can say 0 to 19. So far, it covers the smallest. But because I already know the smallest is 18, that's why I put 18 to 19. Come to value here, up here. There's a value. Click one. No, oh, no, not that one, not that one. There's a space.
Right there.
Yes. So click on that space and type one. The space, type one. Now, immediately you type one, this one become highlighted. Click on hard. That hard become hard become highlighted. Hard. So you are saying that you have coded 18 to 19 to be one. Now go back to the range.
Yeah.
20 to 29. You go and type 2, please. Hope we are following. Everybody is following. Because it's good for us to go and lay our hand and do the same thing. So, I begin to do 2. Type 2. And add. Then 30 to 39. Just do it like that.
Continue. Yeah. 2, 39. That's the third one.
That would be 3.
Then 40 to 49.
You see, it's very simple.
Yes,
4.
Yes.
4. Yes. Yes. Let's be participating. Let me. People will be putting mouths. Not only the men, or even the women. The ladies in the house.
Yes,
that would be thank you. Yeah, that's fine. That's the last one. Because there's not, that's the last one. That's great. You now say continue.
Good.
Okay. Click okay.
Good.
Yes. I want to do, there's something I want you to do, but before you do it, I want you to go and run the analysis first. Or go to your data before you run, go to your, can you see it now? Can you see the column? It has created that age group. Can you see? Can you see? It is there.
Yeah.
If you don't want, you know, normally when it creates something new, by default, it make it 2 decimal places. You may not want the 2 decimal places, so it's not clean. You can go back to variable view. Go to variable view. That's how to. You can remove that decimal, reduce decimal to 0. So if you go back now, you see now, you won't see the decimal there again. Can you see?
Okay.
Now, you may still want to. Okay, if you run the analysis now. Okay, go and run the. Let's run the analysis. We are still coming by. I want you to do something. Run the analysis. Frequency. Under frequency, yes, frequency. Now, return all these other ones that are there and put age group here.
Age group. Go in. Okay.
Click on the. Wait. You know, go to statistic. You know, the last thing you did, you know, one thing with SPSS, the last thing you do, the operation will be there. Uncheck all this because you are not interested because you are not calculating. This one is the age group now. Yes. Remove all those before it start giving you. Thank you. Some people, that's what they will do. They just go and calculate the, even they will calculate the mean age group there. Don't continue. Yes, continue. Now click on the.
Display frequency.
Yeah, display. You know, if you don't know it, it will not do anything for you. It is 0 that will give you. You know, remember that time you didn't want the display frequency for all those things. That's why. Yeah. So anything you did last, in a particular function, you meet it there. Unless you log out and come back, then okay. Okay. Can you see now? Can you see that done the frequency of the age group for you? But there's something we need to label, because sometimes after a while you may forget which one is number one, which one is two. That is what I just want you to see like this first. Now, go back to data editor window.
Data editor window.
So you are you seeing it? I don't know, your own computer is so powerful because you can easily as you go between the and it's showing. Others, it will not even show. You have to be sharing all the time. I don't know. What is the RAM? Anyway, we talk about earlier. Yes, what I want you to do is that let's look at the value. Click on the value, under value for that age group. Click on other value. Other value, yes. Click. Great. Click. Yes. Now click, put one now. Let's label. You know, we have already put them. One, less than. Put less than 20. You know it's less than 21. No, use the sign now. Use the sign. Use the sign. Yes. 20. Hard. 2. You know it's 20 to 29, the way you did it that time. You know, label it. So that when you remember how what you did, yes. But when you want to tablet, it's not 1, 2, you want to tablet. Yes.
40 to 49.
Yes. Then the other ones. Greater than is actually greater than or equal to. That greater than or equal to sign. You will not see it in there. What you can do is that what I usually do, I will now go to Word. Word and now click on the sign in the Word and now copy and paste it there. That's what I usually do. You can go and do it now. There's nothing. Go outside. Go outside Zoom now. And click on the Word document. Open the Word document. Don't do anything. Don't do okay. Don't look, do okay. Just go outside Zoom. Click on Word document and use. It's not moving. It will move. Yes. You don't even need to share. You don't need to share. Just go and type as I
said.
Okay, if you cannot do, just put anything.
Search.
Don't worry.
Search for what?
No, if you go to the Word document, there's symbol insert equal to or greater than. When you insert in a Word document, copy from that Word document, come back and paste it there. That's what I do. And it will stay. Don't worry. Okay. It's okay. It's okay, don't worry, you can leave that one. You can put equal to also.
Okay.
Equal to.
That's greater than equal to. Okay, yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah. Now, you can run it again now, you see. Go and run the analysis again.
You can see.
It's there, don't worry, just take okay, it's there. Can you see now? It's able to give you with the label. Can you see?
Yeah.
So now, if you want to maybe what do I call it? The CD4 can classification. Dr. Olagudo gave us one classification that time. Do you remember? Maybe you want to classify CD4 can into 3. It's the same thing. So 3, 4, but there are some that you just want to have a cutoff. Like for example, now, if let's say you want to say CD4 can greater than or equal to something, how do you do that? That's the way you usually do for your CD4 can less than or equal to something. Or barrel low, greater than or equal to something. You know that I usually do for blood sugar, anemia. Anemia is a hemoglobin concentration less than something. Diabetic is blood sugar greater than or equal to 126. You know, it's just one cut off. It's not like this one that we do range. But if you want to range it to different, this is the way you do it. But let's say you want to do that one. This is the way you do it. Dr. Bako,
yes, sir.
Go to data. You want to do something greater than data, not transform. Go to data. There's a column, data.
Yes. You're there.
Yeah, click on it. And go to the third to the last, fourth to the last, and second to the last, rather, select cases, second to the last, select cases, yes, click. Yes. You see by default, all cases. Click on if condition is satisfied.
See the four pumps.
No, okay. If condition, we have not talked about see the four pumps. If condition. Yeah, click on if now. Immediately you do that if. So move CD4 can. Move CD4 can inside. You notice this is what has less than 200.
Okay, less than.
It may be less than equal to whatever anyone. 200. Just that. Thank you. Just continue. Okay. Click OK. Yes. Now, you go to your data editor window. You will see something.
Kini.
Data editor window. Yes. You will see, can you see?
Camera a filter. Okay.
Filter
on the right side.
You see a filter. Color.
Sorry.
Sorry. You see a filter.
Yeah.
What it does is that all those ones that are less than 200, it gives them one. Yeah, greater than 200 is zero. Now, come to the side. Come to the bar here. All those ones that are less than 200, that are greater than, they are not in that category, it cross them. Those ones that are zero, it cross them out. Are you following now? If let's say I want to do further analysis now, maybe I just want to analyze something. I want to analyze viral load. I want to know or age group only for or skin lesion, yes or no, for only people that are CD4 count less than 200. It will only do that one for me. Well, yeah. Let's go and run it now. Go to analyze. Go to analyze. Descriptive and frequency. Click on skin lesion. Remove this. I just want to give an example. Anyone you can use. Let's click on skin lesion. Let's you want to skill use skin lesion for only people that CD4 count are less than 200. Click OK. Click OK. Scroll down, let's see.
Yes.
Can you see? Yes. It tell you 14. All of them have skin lesion. Yes. Can you see now? What this one just tell you, all the 14, it's only 14 that are in that category that have CD4 count less than 200. And all of them, the thing is yes. So any analysis you do, It's only good for the 14. Because only the 14 you selected. But that's not the only case you use that thing for. Go back to this data editor window, Dr. Bako. Now, go to variable view. Go to variable view. You can actually say, okay, change that filter to CD4 count, just type it. Data down 200. Just change it to this. Just change it. Type it there. You have created a variable that DT is CD4 count greater than 200. Don't use the sign. You use data. You have to type it. CD4 count greater than 200. Greater than 200. Type it. Will it take that greater than? I don't know if we. Okay, let's see. And you see, it will not take, because it's a mathematical operation, it will not take that great act down. Just you have to type it like a word. See, if you can greater than 200, you have to greater than 200. Oh, you see, you have to say above 200. Oh, is it not less than 200? No. Below, less just a see if you can below 200. You are just a see if you can below 200. Below 200 is great. Okay. Now, you can delete this one out, this one in the middle, that label. Because the label, the operation you put, that's what you will, if you leave it there, that's what it will label it, and you do somehow. Okay. Delete it. Okay. Now, click on this select or not select.
Yeah.
What it does, that you are seeing as 1 and 0, that's what it does. The one that is selected, the one that are less than 200 selected. The one that are greater than, that are not, that are greater than 200 or more, they are not selected. So click on that. Click on it. Click on any of them. Click on any of them. Change it to yes. Change that selector to yes. That is, you are saying CD Vulcan below 200. Yes. Change. Click on change. Click on the other one. Type no. Just delete all those and let it remain no. Let it remain no. No is there. No, yeah. Change.
Okay.
Click on change. Okay. Click on change. So what you have just done, okay. Okay. You have created a variable now. See if you can below 200, yes or no. You get it, Bishop, now. Now.
Yes. Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Sorry, I'll take you back a little, sir.
That's great. That's great.
Please. Please, when we're going for this CD core count, so there was a way you split the variables to get the 0 and 1.
Yes, it's one down. Okay, okay, no problem. It's the same thing.
Maybe.
Go there, Dr. Obaku. That's why, if let's say your computer is ready now, it's you that I would say you should demonstrate it. You know, the person that go to data. I just want him to see the place.
We go to data.
You go to data. Here you are following Dr. Anaku. Now go to select cases. Select cases.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, click on it. It will take us by, because by default, it was all cases. Now say, you now click on if condition satisfied. Immediately click on it. You now click on if. You now click on it. Click on if. That's where it shows. Okay. What it does is, what it did was to move CD Vulcan here and now put the sign less than 200.
And yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
That's how to. That's how you do blood sugar also. Blood sugar greater than this. By that you feel it, you now call it diabetic. You now call the variable diabetic. Wow, so yeah, the way we label CD Vulcan below 200.
It's organized.
Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome. You know, that's why we say clinician. Terrible. Somebody that has blood sugar 126 done by diabetes. The person that has 125 is not diabetic.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
I'm just joking because, of course, it's 126 and above. Some people have extremely. I'm just telling you how you can just do cutoff like that. You just change people into
without.
Yes, now it's the same thing in medical school. They say somebody score, just score for the 50, you pass. 50.999,
fail. We can say the qualification for antiretroviral.
50.99, fail. 49.99, rather, fail. 50 per pass. Okay.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Okay. Now, if you go and run that thing now, I want you to do something. Because a mistake that can happen. Go and run, doctor, go to analyze.
Yeah.
Go to descriptive. Go and run the frequency of that, the new variable you created. You see something will happen. The muskin lesion. The muskin lesion. CD4 can below 200. Okay. What happened? He only give you that 14. Yeah. You gonna be only yes.
Only yes.
The reason is that I will tell you, go back to that data, go to data here now. It's showing here also. Go to data. No, you don't need to, you don't even need
up.
Data also is there in you can access it through the data, through the result view. Yeah, go back to that your select. No, select. And result. And you can access it anywhere. Go to that select cases.
Select cases.
You now see all cases. Go back to all cases.
Yes.
Click OK. So it has selected all cases back now. If you go back to your data edition, you will see that line that cross is no more there. Go and run the analysis now.
Okay.
Run the analysis. The analysis you run. I see now. It will show you. You didn't save what you did. You didn't save it. You didn't say okay. That thing that you label yes or no, you didn't say okay. That's why you are having this problem. You understand? You didn't say okay. You didn't okay it.
It's not safe.
Okay. Go back there. Go to data editor window. Okay. And yes. Can you see? Can you see?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. Glory, you know what you did. You know what happened. You know when Dr. Anyaku has you, you did it again. Yes. That's the one you are now using. That's what you use.
Yes.
You understand me now? That's what you want to use. You want to analyze. Yes. Don't worry. But, you know, remove it. No, that's not the issue. Don't worry.
Okay.
Click out. Go and run the analysis. You will see what will happen. You use the wrong one.
Huh?
Are you using
the wrong one?
Yes. You see the one up. Yes, now. Click OK. You see.
Yes,
are you see now?
Yes. They are the same, just that this one is saying yes, no. That's right.
What is talking?
Very interesting.
Okay, stop sharing, Dr. Baku.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, any question? Because I want question. Because this doctor. Thing is a matter of practicing. Yes, Dr. Balogun want to talk.
Yeah, I think we've displayed the table. If we have to run charts on age groups.
Okay, thank you.
How will you do that? Because
thank you. There's a provision for that. A provision for it, even with the as you are running the something. Okay. Okay, let's
so can we run it
on
any of the bar graphs of histogram or pie charts and all that?
That's we can run in that. Yes. When we get to pie, you go to see. Even with that something, you know, if you want to the histogram, you run it with the raw data. We are going there when we want to explore. Maybe we'll do that tomorrow. When we want to explore, we'll do that. When we want to explore for normality, you will see how we can do the histogram there. Then even this one with category, you can do bar chart and pie chart. That's what I'm saying. Okay, Doctor, another person can share. Or Dr. Balogun, share back. Let's see. Before we close. Okay. It's me you are sharing. Yes, great. Okay, go to that, your analyze. Go to analyze, okay. Go to analyze, doctor. Dr. Baku. Are you hearing me? Analyze. Okay. So go to analyze. I want to frequency. You stop sharing. No, so it's me you are sharing.
Wait, sir. Why?
Descriptive.
Who's telling you?
Descriptive. You want? Maybe your this is checking. Descriptive. Go to frequency, just like what you did the other time. Go to frequency. Go to chat. Go to chat. There's chat.
On the right.
Chat on the right. Chat.
On the right.
No, on the on the dialogue.
Below statistics. Below statistics. Yeah.
So this type of thing now is better with pie chart. Put pie chart. Okay, continue. Okay.
Remove display.
And doesn't matter, because it's not okay. Much. Can you see? Okay. It shows the subject. It also showed the chart for us. If you feel that there is a bash, you can put bash out there. Yes or no?
What I'm actually saying is, when you have group data,
yes,
and you want to read it in a pictorial form, sometimes when you do it, what you get is going to be like as if you've not done the value label. The value label sometimes doesn't appear if you run histogram. If you run some this, that's what I'm trying to ask.
Like that's why I said I will do that one tomorrow. I said even the okay, maybe that was the first day you say you were not around. We are going to do that one. That's what I'm saying. You only do that one when we use the data themselves. That is explore. I was tempted to go there. I didn't want to go there because by the time we start going there, issue of transformation will be coming in. That's why I still want to explore. Let's go do this one. So by that, you go to see that how you, the histogram, everything can come out. That's what I was telling you, that even under the analysis, the graph can come out. You don't even need to go to a session on graph with the one they put in there. The graph can come out. Neat graph. But when it comes, still come to all these bash and patch, we still discover the Excel give is cleaner graph. So that's why we prefer using Excel. You hear me now? Plot the graph. Okay. Yes, Hugo. I know that you now have a question that you come back. Okay, go on with your question.
No, I was saying that I was just trying to, because I saw what you did with the bar chart. I wanted to see the how you did the pie chart.
Yes. Okay. Dr. Bako, demonstrate, you have the floor. Be talking now, be talking as you are demonstrating. You are the one demonstrating.
Frequencies.
Okay.
Charts. By charts.
Program. You just see the by chart now? Okay.
So there's a place for charts there. When you click on it, you have the option of pie chart, bar chart, histogram. But of course, the computer will not think for you. It's you that will think, but if you do the wrong thing, it will give you the wrong thing, so it look bizarre. Of course, you know that this is categorical because you are talking of
yes or no.
You have already categorized it. A CD4 below 200, yes 200. Or no. So it's either you use bar chart or pie chart. But of course, for this one, pie chart is better because it's just two categories. We wish are mutually exclusive. You look at the picture now. If let's say that two categories now, you are splitting it, there are two groups, group A and group B. In that case, we'll not use pie chart because if you use pie chart, it will give you two pie chart, but you not you prefer to use bar chart so that you put them side by side. I don't know if you understand me now. So some of these things, when you lay your hand on data, it's good to even play with it. You need to do this one. Let's see what your computer will not explode. If you do the, you lay your hand on data, if you want to give you what is good, what is bad, you're able to learn from it. I don't know if there's any question that we can close for today, at least from what's the time now? We are born time from 10, from 8 to 11. So that's a good one. Have we learned anything today? If there's any question, let us know. Because you that want to, the longer the video, the difficult to upload. You that want the video. So that's another. Stop sharing, Dr. Baku. Thank you. Dr. Baku, stop sharing. Dr. Baku, stop sharing.
So maybe you can be split.
I can be what?
The video into one.
Okay, maybe we should stop. Okay, yes, Tusha. Maybe that's what we have to stop and log in.
And do the recording in one-hour sessions so that the video
will not be too large. I agree with you. So maybe that's what will happen. Once you do 1 hour, I will close it and log in again. Because if you close it, if you pause, it will not do anything. So if you close it, okay, maybe I should close it now and now ask for question. Let me just...
Yeah, it will be easier to upload the video.
Yes, I can come back, no problem. Dr. Baku, stop.
Okay. Yes.
Stop. Dr. Baku. Don't worry. Stop your sharing. Dr. Baku, stop sharing. Stop sharing.
I'll stop that.
Yeah,
you are not stop sharing.